Hello everyone, now we will solve one more question for the same sectional orthographic projections. Now this is the given object, direction is given for front view. Now what is there in this object? If you see from this side, this area will be visible, this cylindrical part will be visible, and this cylindrical part. Inside the cylindrical part there is one groove, and here also one keyhole is present with one rib. Now I have told you, whenever we have to solve a question of sectional orthographic projection, we have to follow three steps. Draw the normal orthography, convert the hidden line into object line, then you have to draw section line with hatching. So just to make it more clear, I have drawn one sectional object, means if I have to cut, we have to do the full section, means we have to cut fully the object like this, means we have to cut it from here, passing from here and then here. When we have to cut and remove this part, this is the remaining portion. In short, I can say you are going to draw the full sectional front view of this, means this is the front view. This question can come for full or half, but we are solving for the full, so we are not solving for the half, remember this. Now first step, draw the normal orthographic projection. Now what will be the normal orthographic projection? Here you can see a straight line and a cylinder, here also a cylinder. I have discussed all these orthographic views in the previous videos. So if you have any doubt in that, you just try to follow those videos and it will be more clear if you do practice according to those videos. So this is the normal front view. Depth is not given, that is why I am taking throughout. So there is one keyhole, so that is why it is having two hidden lines here in the front view. Now then the top view, this circle and this curve, same here. A bigger circle and more bigger circle, it will have the two tangents here and here, then a part is there, but here it is not only the circle, it is having the keyhole, so it will have this type of structure in the top view, right? So this is the front view and top view. Just to show you orthography, I am making the side view. Just to improve your imagination, I am giving you the side view also. Please try to do the practice on it own. So it depends where it will come as per the dimension, so you have to check. So this is the side view. Just to cross check, you draw the side view and try to see, here it will have one more hidden line for the keyhole. Okay, so try to compare your diagram. Now my main focus is on sectional view. So first step, we have done normal orthography, then you have to convert the hidden line into object line. So when you cut and remove this part, this is the object. So it means these edges of the object which was not visible, but now they are visible. That is the meaning of second step, convert the hidden line into object line, which are coming under sectioning. So this is coming under sectioning, and this keyhole, it will also be dark now. Now this base, it will be present in the object or might not be present. It depends how you are taking the objects. Let's say we are not taking this, means in this object you are taking this surface and this one as the same single surface, but here I have taken this base because I am taking this surface and the rib as the separate one. So that is why in my diagram it will be present, this surface and this one. So we have to draw this as a dark line. Now we have converted all the hidden lines into object lines. Now we will draw in the top view the section line. This section line will come in the top view just to show you the position from where we are cutting the object. Now we have to do the hatching. So this is the area where blade is making the contact with the object, so we have to do the hatching of that area as per the rules. So this view we are going to make on the sheet. Now I will draw this view taking the dimension from here, and the total 64 is there, so I need more space in the top view. I draw the XY line. We are solving it in first quadrant, so VP above, HP below. Now after that, what I have to do, we have to take two grid point gap here. Done with that. Now the total dimension, how to calculate total dimension from this mid to this, it is given 100 plus radius of this 64, half 32, so 100 plus 32, 132, then again half of this, this is diameter 42, outer 21, so 100 plus 32, 132 plus 21, 153.
So total length of this is 153. So I'm taking it 153, right? Now after that, what we have to do, we have to take the height 24. So from this I'm taking height 10 20 24. You have to draw very quickly the diagram, because in exam you will have only 10 to 15 minutes. So this is height 36, so on this side you have to take 36. Right, now after that you can see here I'm taking the help of this this diagram with the dimensions. Now it is having diameter, that is 64. So I'll directly take 64. Very quickly take the dimensions, try to draw exact horizontal line. Done with this, then this smaller, it is having 42. So I'll take exactly horizontal 42. Now after that I have to join them for the rib. Done with this. Now after that it is having this part. Now I'm going for this part. This is 12, it is 24, so this is 12. Just do the practice of calculating the dimensions in exam. In questions they will not give you all the dimensions directly, you have to do calculation. Now this is 12, here it was 36 minus 12, so this is 24. So from this I'm taking 24. Done. After that, if you are doing the question like this, means you are taking the two separate surfaces. So I'm making this line, I'm joining this, taking rib as the separate object. Done with this. Now there is the internal diameter. What is that internal diameter? That is 36. So I have marked the center point. So this is 64, that is 32. So you got this center point. Now about the center point, it is internal diameter 36. So 36 means 18, 18 both side, 10, 8 on this side, 10, 8 on this side. Without sectional front view, it will have the object line, hidden line here, but sectional view, it will have the object line. Done with this. Now after that, there is a keyhole. From this, it is 4 only. So I'll take directly from this point, I'll take 4 directly and mark this keyhole. Done with this. I'm taking the holes throughout, right? Same on this side. At the mid, it is having internal diameter 24. So I'll take 42, mid 21. After that, after 21, it is 24. So 12 on this side, 12 on this side. While drawing, learn how to calculate the dimensions. Very quickly you should draw this. So this is the front view. Now we have to draw the hatching. Now where the blade will touch, in this area and in this area. No need to make the hatching here, this is rib part. So I have told you how to do the hatching. From any corner of the drawing, assume the baseline horizontal, take the 45 angle for the reference line, mark this point. Okay, so we draw this. Now I have told you, take the help of this, the drawn this line, if you can see this line which is already there, it put it on the drawn line, then give the gap, and continuously you can take the hatch lines. In every scale, if you focus on this area, it will be in the range of 2 to 5 mm. No need to worry about the gap, it will come exactly parallel and constant gap between 2 to 5 mm. Remember that, continuous in the same throughout the diagram, continuous line must go for hatching. Like this, same you can follow on this side also. Very quickly we have to complete the diagram. Please try to make the diagram within 10 minutes so that in exam you can solve the same complete diagram within 10 minutes. right? So this is the front view, sectional front view. Now we have to make the top view. I have told you to make the top view, take the projection lines, be quick. Take the projection lines downward from each and every part of the object. Actually, I have followed those three rules in the freehand sketch. First, I have drawn the normal front view, top view. After that, I have drawn the I have converted the hidden lines into object line, and then I have drawn the section line, and then I have made the hatching. Now here I am making the same direct front view, so that is why I am not following those three rules. Now the diameter is 64, so I have to take the dimension so that it should come. So if I leave two grid point here, after that I have to take 64 diameter. So I will directly mark 32 for the midpoint of the circle and then 64 as the diameter. So this is my question. Here it will come like this. Now I can make the horizontal center line just to make it easy while drawing the circles, right? After that, you can, if you want, you can take the middle line, center line from front to top also. One long, one short line, proper formation of center line. For this also, we have marked the center point at the top. So you can take directly the projection line, it will help you in top view. Now after that, I will erase the extra lines. Now we have to start with the circles. So first, the internal circle. So I have drawn the required circle in the top view. Now I have to make the tangent. Just I join it. Put the scale and join it. Just a tangent on the two circles. Wherever it is just joining, just draw that. Right? Now inside there is a rib of 12. So on this side, so from this 6, 6 both side. So I'll mark 6 on this side and 6 on this side. Two straight lines for the rib part. Like this. Now here is one keyhole. Keyhole is having a value of this projection. Right? So we will follow the same. That is what? 8. So 8 means 4, 4 both side. So from this side, I have to mark 8, 4, 4. This is the... Now I can erase this part of circle to make the keyhole. Now I will make the straight part this, straight part this. Sharpen pencil after a few lines, otherwise it will start making the thick lines like I have done this here. So this is the mistake. Sharpen your line after making few lines. So this is the front view and top view. Now in the top view there must be a section line. So I have drawn the center line. I will convert the same center line into section line. How? Only the outermost edge is dark. I have told you what is the section line. It will have the same shape of center line, but only outermost edge is dark. So that is why I made this and this thick. Now it becomes section line. We are cutting the object from here. Now I'll do the dimensioning.